Welcome to the Draw Born. Welcome to our production of the Paul Michael Vibe Josh. The running time for this show is 45 minutes. I'll just take you through the content warnings if you didn't see it at the door. So we've got homophobia, staging of gay conversion practices, blasphemy, emetophobia, religion, Bible references, loud ringing noises, and rapid lighting changes. So anyway, enjoy the show. We'll see you again.
In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. And then God said, "Let there be light." And there was light, and he saw that the light was good. And God saw the light.
And thus began a very, very busy 6 days. Why, out of interest, are you reciting Genesis?
It makes sense to start from the beginning, doesn't it?
Actually, no. I like to skip to the good bits.
Of course you do.
What does that mean?
Well, go on then. What's the good bits?
Luke chapter 1.
That's you.
What?
You're in Luke chapter 1.
Am I?
Delivered the message to Nazareth.
Oh yeah, it is. Happy coincidence.
So, did you speak to him yet?
What? Oh no, I couldn't find him.
What?
Don't worry, he's there somewhere.
He's been gone too long.
Oh, please. You and I both know time does not work that way up here. Or at all, really.
Patronizing.
Also, he is everywhere at all times. And every when. Is it every when or...
Gabriel.
Michael.
Please treat this seriously.
Cross my heart. Look. We have an opportunity here.
We do?
To relax, you know. Have some fun. We've got no people to guide, no messages to deliver.
So?
So, we should... Huh? We should race!
What now?
Yeah, come on, a race in the sky. Because I was thinking, obviously you're smaller, so you'd be lighter, but then I'm taller, so I've got bigger wings.
No.
Oh, come on, we can get the cherubim to referee.
No.
Okay. Is it because you think you'd lose?
I just don't think we should revel in his absence.
He'll make himself known soon.
I know. I just... Thank you.
You won't find all the answers in there, you know.
Because you're a wealth of omniscient knowledge.
I was actually thinking of adding a little something to it.
To the Bible?
I mean, our creation story isn't in there, is it? I'd have that.
Oh, you know our creation.
Well, yeah, it would have been when this was created and the lights.
Is that the first thing you remember? The light?
Yeah. No, kind of. It was more the warmth than anything. I know it doesn't really matter, but it just feels important to me.
The scripture is not particularly clear.
Shocking.
On Gabriel. Yeah. It's still God's word.
Yes, I know.
Just have a bit of respect.
Well then, smite me where I stand. Jesus Christ!
Jesus. I don't think I was him. It's not a style.
Oh my God.
Ow! Blasphemer.
What?
Blasphemy.
You just hit me with a Bible. Do you not see the irony in that? Yeah, well. Is everything okay?
He'll be here somewhere. He won't have just disappeared.
Are you telling me that, or...?
I
What is it you're actually looking for in there?
I don't know.
Right.
Something that might help us find him.
Okay.
I'll know when I see him.
Oh, I'm sure. Right, maybe it was his plan.
What is
it? Right, hear me out. Maybe the reason God went AWOL is because he knows we need to relax. And he knows that I'd ask you to race. So, we should race. Because I'm really keen to find out the rules.
He doesn't just go AWOL.
You'd be surprised.
Oh, and he wants to host an angelic sports day, does he?
Look, all I'm saying is I know God knows everything. But what happens if there's just one tiny thing he doesn't know? And that's who's a faster flyer. Because I'm really curious about the aerodynamics. The aerodynamics of...
Gabriel?
Yeah? You know what, I'm not really feeling a big performance right now, so the results of a race would be skewed anyway. I'll go and look for him now.
No, you don't have to.
No, it's fine, I'll find him. Hey, it's gonna be okay, Michael. Look, you find what you're looking for in there, and I'll search heaven and earth to God. Don't worry. We'll find him.
Gabriel, wait.
What is it?
Satan said unto the Lord, Dost Job fear God for naught? Hast thou not made a hedge about him, and about his house, and about all that he hath on every side? But put forth thine hand now, and he will curse thee. And the Lord said unto Satan, Bet! He did not say bet.
Might as well have done. Plus, I don't sound like that anymore. Everyone changes.
Not everyone. What are you doing here?
Oh, I was in the neighbourhood. Thought I'd drop in.
Right.
Is that what you think? You wouldn't believe me if I told you.
What's that supposed to mean?
No, you know what? But I don't want to know. I don't want to know. Just leave.
Oh, but honey, I just got home.
This isn't your home anymore. You don't belong here. Hey, I belong here just as much as you do, old friend. Even more so. I had to walk up here.
And why is that?
Touché. You should go.
Do you like games, Michael? Well, I do! And so does God. That's what this is. A game.
Oh, come on. You must know that God and I like to play together. Why else do you think we killed Job's entire family?
A bargain.
Quite competitive, you know.
A bargain, it was, yes. God won.
Did he?
Your other games don't involve God disappearing.
No?
What's different this time?
Well, I got
bored. So, I suggested we play a new game. Have you heard of hide and seek?
Hide and seek?
Yeah, it's a game where one player closes their eyes and counts to an agreed upon.
Okay, yes, I know what hide and seek is.
Perfect.
You were playing hide and seek with God.
Yeah, which I thought would be a little easier, you know, seeing as he's everywhere at all times.
You were right. I don't believe you.
I wouldn't lie to you.
Of course you wouldn't.
Wound me. There, I'll swear it on the Bible.
No, wait.
Oh, it doesn't burn. Well, it means nothing to you. Just put it down. Separate them, apart from God, of course, is mortal love.
Oh, you have gotten bold, my God! God's absence, no less! How unholy!
Oh, Gabriel's feather.
You don't understand that.
And I don't know what's worse. The actual deed itself of... Or the perversion has caused you to act in such an indecent way.
What?
Don't worry, I'm mean to you then.
I don't think it's perverse.
Well, then again, I'm not holy.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I mean, I don't blame you. Gabriel really knew how to
get a girl going.
All right, darling. Sky flight. How many stars God decided to switch on?
Let's try that on a new
year. Stop it! Why? You've clearly gone to great lengths to pursue your infatuation. I mean, I suspected it back then, but you've gone rogue. Well done, Michael.
You know what you're talking about.
Don't I? You've stolen one of his feathers. You and I both know what that means. What you feel.
I don't know what I feel.
That, I think, is true. You know, where I come from, it's quite natural.
You mean hell?
God, no! Earth! The natural world. Raccoons? Salmon? Primates, dolphins, giraffes, chickens, dogs,
God's creations.
Well, yeah, I suppose. Then again, you're not a dog, are you?
What?
I just don't think you should be getting your hopes up.
I wasn't.
You're not an animal.
Meaning?
Meaning you know better. God, aren't you supposed to be the theologian among us? Leviticus 18:22.
I know it.
Humour me.
No.
Suit yourself.
Thou
shalt not lie with mankind as with womankind. It is an abomination.
Shall we consult some other translations? I'm not really a King James Version girl myself. Oh, New International. Do not have sexual relations with a man as you would a woman. That is detestable. Okay. Oh, now a few other oral translations kind of shift the focus to paedophilia and infidelity. So you might have some leeway there. Modern contemporary English. It is disgusting for a man to have sex with another man. Charming, isn't it?
Why are you doing this?
Oh, I'm just trying to find a workaround here.
Just stop it.
Oh, what if we tell God that Gabriel forced you?
No, no!
Yeah, you're right. God is scary good at telling when you're lying.
I said stop it! Stop it! Lucifer, I know what you're doing, and it won't work. You are a pathetic, lonely Machiavellian.
You're totally damned!
And I won't join you.
I don't find anything sadder than an angel with no wings.
And I don't find much funnier than an angel about to lose theirs.
I won't.
You didn't answer my question before.
Leave.
Do you like games?
I'm not playing games.
How about if I find God, I'll tell him all the little perversions you and Gabriel began up to.
What? No, that's, no,
under
we have
his nose.
We haven't.
No? Oh, I'm sure you can clean up any details that I might get wrong.
You won't believe me.
No? Nah, probably not. You willing to bet your wings on it?
How is this a game?
No. No, you're right. You need a chance to win. You may talk to God before me, if you'd like, and I'll...
How is that fair? It ends in the same way.
No, not necessarily.
I don't see it.
Oh, God, are you really that arrogant? You've forgotten God's truest nature. Love and forgiveness. I mean, why am I telling you this?
I am not wrong to fear his wrath. But you are right. I am wrong to doubt him.
Just look at me!
You are fallen.
Fallen, but still here! It'd be really best coming from you.
It would be best untold.
And that is where we disagree. It'll liberate you, Michael. In one way or another.
You can't think this is a kindness.
Well, yeah, actually. It's your choice.
Oh no, it isn't.
Come out, whatever you are!
If any man among you seem to be religious, and bridleth not his tongue, but deceiveth his own heart, this man's religion is vain. This man's religion is vain. God? Father, I need to talk to you. It's about me. It's about how I feel. Father? Dad, please answer me. I need to do this. I have to do this.
You love me.
I mean, I know you love me. I've read it enough times. And I feel safe with you. And I feel comfortable with you. And I don't want that to go away. But it will.
I know it will. I know after this, you won't. It won't be the same. Which I understand. I really, really understand. But I can't help it. But maybe you can. Please, could you just make it go away? Please. I think that I am. And I don't want to be. I really don't want to be. But I think that I am, and I feel scared. I don't think I've ever felt scared before. Not like this. Not so much that you can't stop shaking, and you can't speak right, and you finally understand wanting to be swallowed up by the earth, to be trapped in the earth and the soil and the dirt, rather than just being left here, exposed and alone. I really don't know how to do this. I think that I am. I think that I can't I say it? Oh, I don't know why I can't. I just can't. I just, that word, it just won't come out. I like guys. Did you hear me? Did you? Please say something. Why are you silent, Father? I understand that you're ashamed, that you're disgusted. I like men. Well, go on then. Why don't you burn me? Why don't you end me? Damn me! Cast me out! Go on! Why are you silent? You are cruel. You made me this way. You say nothing. I am not Job, or a test, or a struggle, or a bargain. You made me this way. You made me this way. You made me this way, and you're just saying no. Forgive me, Father, please. You made me nothing, I know. Forgive me anyway.
Game is up.
And you're still here!
Winged! I'm glad.
No, you're not.
I am.
Little. It's because God has his favourite.
He didn't hear me. He didn't come.
You don't know that.
Oh, I do. I do know it.
Thank you.
it will help. You know it will. Just one.
Here. Okay. I'll come back.
Don't, please.
And so we know and rely on the love God has for us. God is love. Those who live in love live in God. And God in them. Love is made complete so that we will have confidence on the day of judgment. In this world, we are like Jesus. There is no fear in love, but perfect love drives out fear, because fear has to do with punishment. Those who fear are not made perfect in love. Are you alright, Michael?
Yes.
Okay. Are you going to ask me?
Ask you what?
Whether I found God!
It's okay, I'm sure he's fine.
What? He is. Now you listen to me!
I'm sorry you wasted your time.
No, I didn't waste my time, I found it!
What?
Yeah, it took a while, but mission accomplished, Archangel.
Unbelievable.
Yeah, well, technically he found me.
Stop it!
Oh, what is going on?
Don't touch me!
Okay, fuck
it. I'm sorry. It just makes me feel sick to my stomach. Oh God, I feel sick.
What, when I...
No, I don't think, technically he found me, what does that mean?
Well, I was close to calling it quits, and then bam, he just appeared. You know how he does.
he didn't want to see me, he didn't want to hear me.
Is that what this is about?
I needed him, Gabriel. I needed him, and he wasn't there.
Right, well, I'm sure he'll explain. I would go and find him,
but... No. Please, stay.
Okay.
I needed his help when you were gone, Gabriel. I asked God for help, and he didn't answer.
So, what?
Excuse me?
Don't get mad. I'm just trying to understand. You needed God's help. And he did not provide this time. So what? Your faith is stronger than that, Michael.
I don't know if it is. And not this.
What do you mean? What is this? What were you asking for?
I can't say.
You can't say?
I don't know. Acceptance?
Michael!
Yes, and despite how selfish it sounds, I needed 5 minutes. Just 5 minutes of his attention.
God only provides one constant, Michael.
Love.
Unconditional love. You get your truth in here, don't you? Isaiah 41:10. Fear thou not, for I am with thee.
And please, just no more scripture.
Alright. I only brought it up because you used to depend on that. Look, you lost faith. It happens. Now find it again. It doesn't have to be in there. It can be anywhere, anything. Anyone?
Bravo!
Lucy!
Gabriel, darling.
How long has it been?
Too long.
How are things? How's health?
Hot.
Yeah, I see some things never change.
You know what? Michael here said that exact same thing.
I told you not to come back.
Did you? I don't recall.
I've come to help.
You've done enough.
Whoa. Okay. I'm sensing some tension here. A little frustration.
Wow, Gabriel, are you an empath?
I am.
You wasn't serious. Look, I'm sorry. I've come to solve all your problems.
Lucy, what did she just do?
Fixed it. There you are. Better now.
How will that fix anything?
Well, you don't have to look at it anymore.
you can't just take that one page out of every Bible out of people's words out of their minds.
I don't understand. How is this one page ruining your life?
Well, excuse me for trying to help.
Lucy, let me see.
Wait, no. Please.
I don't understand. There's a lot of words here. Oh. Oh.
Good stuff, baby.
Michael, look at me.
No.
What were you thinking?
I wasn't thinking.
Yeah, clearly not. But you didn't skip to the good bits. You skipped to the very, very bad bits. Why?
What?
This is what you've been carrying around this whole time. Can you believe this?
Please don't judge me, Gabriel.
Absolutely I will judge you. You had your whole crisis over just this.
Just?
God will not cast you out for one page, Michael. Don't forget what this one had to do to film.
Why?
Started an entire angelic rebellion.
Yeah, when you were close to joining.
I was not close.
I think you were.
You're not going to bait me.
No, well, it would have taken much.
Was what?
I think I need to fall. I want to fall.
You're going to be okay, Mark.
I know I am. I just won't be. Here.
What does that mean?
I would really condemn myself.
I've told you. That doesn't matter.
But it's not just that. It's the lying, and the anger, and the fear.
Well, you were conflicted.
Oh, I'll say.
It's not angelic. And I haven't been for a while.
You are an angel,
yes,
Mark.
Yes, I know. But I don't feel it. But the shame, it weighs me down.
Just ignore it.
What?
Huh?
Just don't think about it. Just never act on it.
I can't do that, Gabriel.
Well, you have to deal with all of it up here, though.
Nah. I say jump.
Well, of course you would.
Well, he's obviously made up his mind. Now he's being manipulated.
To try and save him?
What do you think I was doing?
I can't stay, Gabriel.
Well, I'm sorry, but you will. I won't let you fall.
I just took your feather. Stole it. I don't know. If none of the rest of it matters to you, then that should.
My feather?
Do you see now?
Oh. It was me.
And the penny drop.
Yeah. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
You understand why I have to do this now? Did it hurt?
What? When I fell from heaven?
Yes.
Only what I allowed myself to feel.
But how will you make yourself feel?
Will you help me?
I bet you only took my feather to give you an edge in that race, didn't you?
Mike, are you here with me?
This isn't a prison, Mike. You can leave at any time.
You requested a Bible when you checked in, but we can remove it if it's upsetting you.
No, no. It helps.
You okay to continue? Have you been taking your apomorphine as instructed?
I wanted you to take one to see, or to see how much you could manage. I want you to take three now. I'm going to ask my assistant to step in now. Mike, this is Gabe. He's going to be helping with today's session. Do you like the look of Gabe, Mike? Do you think he's attractive?
No.
Would you want to touch him? I see. I'm going to show you some photos now, Mike. They're of Gabe. Now I want you to look at them. Alright? Really look at them. Do you understand? Touch him now. Would you want to touch yourself? That's right. It's all right. It's all right. This is good. Let it out. It's good. It's good. It's all right, right? You're all right.
Just stop.
Dear Mrs. I gather from your letter that your son is a homosexual. I'm most impressed by the fact that you do not mention this term yourself in your information about him. May I question why you avoid it? Homosexuality is assuredly no advantage. It is nothing to be ashamed of. No vice, no degradation. It cannot be classified as an illness. We consider it to be a variation of the sexual function produced by a certain arrest of sexual development. Many highly respectable individuals of ancient and modern times have been homosexuals. Several of the greatest men among them. Plato, Michelangelo, Leonardo da Vinci, etc. It is a great injustice to persecute homosexuality as a crime, and cruelty too. If you do not believe me, read the books of Havelock Ellis.
By asking me if I can help, you mean, I suppose, if I can abolish homosexuality and make normal heterosexuality take its place.
The answer is, in a general way, we cannot promise to achieve it. In a certain number of cases, we succeed in developing the blighted germs of heterosexual tendencies, which are present in every homosexual. In the majority of cases, it is no more possible. It is a question of the quality and the age of the individual. The results of treatment cannot be predicted.
What analysis can do for your son runs in a different line. If he is unhappy, neurotic, torn by conflicts, inhibited in his social life, analysis may bring harmony, peace of mind, full efficiency, whether he remains a homosexual or gets changed.
Otherwise, if you want to catch us for drinks or afterwards, that would be lovely. Thank you so much for coming.